loud, loud, loud. Very loud.
Good morning, everyone. We are here to discuss on the topic are women protection acts, are they just remaining acts? So I strongly agree with the statement that woman is always the best creation of God, be it in the form of a mother, a wife, or a sister, or a friend. So I feel it's our sole duty that we try our best to protect them and to ensure their safety. So currently, I feel there is no much action regarding this. As we can see, the crime rate against women is increasing at a very rapid pace. Sufficient steps have to be taken and awareness has to be spread, not only just to protect women, but we should make people realize why we have to protect women and what a woman is.
Considering all these factors, like women are the, what is the mother of everyone, like providing this much of rights for them, they may implement those in positive manner or they can use it in misuse them. Okay. Misusing the rights may cause many of the disadvantages to others. Women have very powerful rights for them. They said other constitution, like the rules provided for them are very powerful. Like if they have any complaint on others, they are very punishable. Like there's a chance of misusing those rights on others for the grudge or something else.
Actually, before speaking about the misuse of acts, let us speak about the implementation of the acts. And we see only few incidents coming to hype that this kind of harassment has been done to the particular girl or a woman. Actually, we don't see many of the things which are happening in this world, in this world. Actually, many more things are happening in the working world or house or anything else, but only some come into the hype, like the Nirbhaya case or something else. And at that point of time, the government or the acts act very, very fast, and they pretend like they're acting or they're punishing the people, but they don't do. But after a few weeks or a few days, the hype will be continued, and then later on it decreases, and after some years, they'll take action. So if this continues, and the person who gets the thought of attempting a crime on women, he'll never lose that thought. So what happens, only 2-3 weeks, people remember me about this type, about this crime, and then on they'll forget, so it's not a big deal to do a crime against. Actually, what is, we have to implement the acts what are present on the women, and we have to actually modify the acts. You know, like there are very brutal incidents what people are trying to commit on women, and in the same instant, we have to reflect the same punishments what they are doing. You know, we don't need to keep all the investigations. Investigations have to be made to make whether they are real or not. Once you confirm that the incident was done by a particular person, the punishment must be brutal. And that creates a fear in the person who gets that thought. And I think this is not happening in the present day. And that's a big problem.
Okay, after committing some brutal incidents on the women, the person who commits this should have a fear about that. These rules are, rules will bother me. Okay. If he is in a dilemma like, I won't be punished for this many of years, what is the fear for me to commit this kind of events? But there's implementation of rules of all these cases, but these rules are very slowing down. These are not, rapid.
The prolonged 2 years should take charge.
They should change the constitution, like these punishments should be rapidly acted. like in some countries there's an acts like the shouldn't say daughters from this men's for the women total act.
And on the add on this point discussion, the rules of India is the rules of Arabian countries are much better than India, because the rules of Arabian countries, any harassment taken to the girl, then at the spot the man was killed by that Arabian girl.
But in that point of view, there is a very few chance of misusing the particular right, and time must be taken to.
And we should also consider the elders who have given all these constitutional laws. They would have kept in mind that they were not revolutionaries. They would have thought of every effect, and they would have framed this constitution with all relevant thoughts. So the procedure of law, as we know in India, is it's not spontaneous, and it's not the case prolongs for a long time and the judgment is given. I do agree that there is a chance for women to completely misuse the rights, but I feel the necessity of implementing this laws overrules the chances of misuse by the women. So the acts should be taken seriously, and the importance of women and what she is has to be spread among the people. And whenever possible, I agree that all security measures are being taken, and many MNC companies in which women do work for night shifts, they do have security facilities. When they have their pick and drop facilities, they do employ a security guard with them at night. But people should think of the fact that what about the security guard? Because we can't predict anything these days. And the and we have seen many cases wherein the policemen and the cops itself were involved in committing crimes against women. So I think it's more of the mental awareness which has to be spread among people. How much about security measures you take, it's reliable only when people understand that there is a strong reason to respect.
If you look on the other side of issues of women's rights, we can understand there are numerous cases being registered every year in harassment. And we can see many acid attacks and many other kinds of attacks on women. So there is an urgent need for the government to give women some extra power than men in order to equalize the power.
As you give the extra powers to women, their chance of misusing also increases.
There is no need to give extra powers to women. Our PM Narendra Modi gave the equal chances to women also. Out of 21 cabinet ministers, 12 to 13 women are there, and they are ruling India.
Women should know the rights, what kind of rights they have, and they should know how to utilize them. As you have said, the security reasons is definitely is a burning issue today. And recently, see in Kolkata, a woman, and she is a pregnant woman, she was identified in her own choice. And what kind of security provided by what kind of security has been to her in such a condition? I feel the chance of misuse is pretty less, because no woman wants to defame herself. Well, she doesn't want to say that she has undergone some tragic incident in her life, because it itself is a kind of insult for her. So this chance of misuse arises when she has a real grudge on someone or something like that. When there are chances of misuse, instead of reducing her powers, why not analyze the fact that if she is really misusing, or she is lodging a genuine complaint? Why not increase the intelligence acts, and why not increase the investigation procedures, so that we are sure that the complaint which has been lodged by her is genuine and not.
Actually, to conclude, whether the women protection rights are acting effective or not, that is a secondary thing. And women, the protection of women is in our hands, and being a man, we should respect the world's finest creation. And it is in our hands whether the woman is facing this kind of harassment or not. And what I feel is keeping the secondary act, I mean the implementation of acts and what are the women acts you have. Before that, every man should know that we have to respect a mother and a woman, a sister and every girl and the world's finest creation. That is what.
Yes, I agree with this conclusion, and I would just like to add a point to this conclusion. By providing many facilities to women, by increasing the security, I think there is not going to be any major change. We need to make them self-sufficient to protect themselves. We recently have electric torches, which can be used as a self-protection instrument. And we can also give them human protection instruments like pistols, and thereby we can protect them.